Hyderabad today, you know, lot of us, including myself, have complaints without a question. We can be better, we can do better, we can do much better, in fact. But in spite of this, I'm not going to give you comfort, relative comfort. Kani, ee roju kuda Hyderabad, still, when compared to Bangalore, when compared to Chennai, when compared to other cities, we definitely have better infrastructure. When you travel outside and come back, you'll realize that. Aithe, I'm not happy. I'm not happy with the existing infrastructure in Hyderabad. Ultimately, Hyderabad infrastructure ki mukhyanga Hyderabad lo unde sewerage system mottam aadhunikarinchali. Ikkada unde storm water drains ni inka baagu cheyali. Ivanni cheyalante dadapuga naku mottam raaboye 3-4 ella kaalamlo oka 50 nunchi 55000 crore padutundi. Endukante unless you get your drains right, unless you get your sewerage system right, unless you get your storm water drains sorted, you'll not be able to get good roads. You'll not be able to have roads which will last a longer term. So therefore, our priority is going to be focusing on urban infrastructure, including sewerage treatment plants, including insurance. See, once Mission Bhagirath is completed, we'll have a lot of liquid wastage. So you'll have to also address the issue of sewerage treatment and liquid waste management. That is going to be a priority. Same is the case with solid waste management in a city like Hyderabad, where today we are generating almost 5,000 metric tons of waste every single day. Now that also has to be incinerated, that also has to be produced, converted into another form of energy or another form of useful material which can be again recycled. So the third thing I would say, on health and education, we've made some progress, but I think a lot more has to be done. For example, we've improved institutional deliveries almost by 30%. We've gotten the IMR down, we've gotten the MMR down, infant mortality rate and maternal mortality rates have come down significantly in Telangana. Institutional deliveries, like I mentioned, have shot up by 30%. We've been able to, especially in the rural areas, been able to improve the confidence of people in government institutions. Even in Hyderabad, we've launched Basti Dawakhanas in the lines of Mohalla clinics in Delhi. And I'm delighted with the response they've received. We already have 45 up and running. In fact, I went exactly across the road. There is one in Begumpet. So one day I walked in as a random check. What happens is, there were about 40 odd people around 2 o'clock in the afternoon. And when I asked them, so how was it going, you know, I was generally chatting with them. This was a random check. So they said, sir, there were about 4 dispensaries around this area, private. All of them have shut shop because Basti Dawakhana has come. While these are drops in the ocean, these are all drops in the ocean, they all do count. Because ultimately when you're able to inspire confidence of people in public institutions, be it on the health front or education, only then would you succeed completely. So I would say urban infra, health, education and completing irrigation projects. In that order or maybe slightly here and there, but that would be the top priority.
One aspect, whenever we discuss in particular about China, is we realize despite liberalization in 91, we have fallen behind in manufacturing. And even work you've done in encouraging entrepreneurship, T-Hub, there seems to be this kind of bias towards technology, which is not held against you. But in the next 5 years, do you think you will make Telangana and Hyderabad perform much better in manufacturing than any other state in India? What kind of thoughts do you have? And how do you co-opt these people who are all representatives of what would fit in the MSME kind of a segment? How can they be part of that vibrant manufacturing vision of the state?
Sriram, let me point out 2 things. Firstly, this comparison between China and India is extremely oversimplified. A lot of people make that mistake of this oversimplified comparison of China and India. Just because we are of similar sizes, you know, large countries, people make that comparison. But the fact is, China is a country, India is a continent. India is hugely diverse, very heterogeneous, and more importantly, India is a democracy. Now, in a democracy, while things might take time to get done, but when they get done, they'll have a long-lasting and a more permanent impact is what I would like to believe. And I believe world over, if you see, you look at USSR and everything that has fallen apart right in front of our eyes when we were growing up. You know, USSR, in fact, at one point of time, I don't know, superpower at one point, yes, I was looking to see how many kids in the room, you know, who actually don't know what USSR is. And I'm sure there are. See, when I was in school, there was always this rivalry between the US and the USSR and the Cold War. You know, I'm glad so many people who actually are of my age as well. So, if you look at it, within no time, the way USSR just disintegrated, you know, right after Gorbachev, was a shocking commentary on how quickly things could fall apart, even for a country like USSR, which was considered a mighty superpower, which was ready to take on the United States. Now, that is why I strongly believe that, you know, this whole bubble or myth of China and how it produces world's 40% of this and 60% of that, you know, that also might, I won't wish it for them, but I do believe that there are a lot of layers underneath which could make it quickly fall apart. Today China is getting very, very expensive, by the way. Yes. For manufacturing, in fact, it's getting very, very expensive. Now, going back to your question about what can Telangana do, you have to understand, and all of you in the room also have to understand, one thing with respect to Make in India campaign that was launched by Prime Minister Modi. See, the launch, the intent, I do not doubt it. I do not doubt the intention of the man. I do not have much to say about, I mean, let me put it this way. I'll not trash the intention. But the fact is, Make in India, today, we have, I think, about 6 mobile companies manufacturing in Telangana. But when I say manufacturing, I have to say it with a pinch of salt. These guys are actually assembling. They're not manufacturing here. None of them are. They're just merely importing material from China or elsewhere and just assembling them here and calling it Make in India, which is not what Make in India is all about. Make in India, if you really have to make mobile phones or computers or electronic goods in India, we'll need initially at least a fab, which India does not have yet. A small country like Taiwan has multiple fabs. Country like China has many, many fabs. Even countries like Malaysia and others, where Chinese companies have gone in and set up fabs, we all know what has happened there and how that has changed their economies. Unfortunately, today, even when Apple wants to manufacture iPhones in India, today, the small unit they do in Bangalore today, where they are manufacturing 5,000 to 10,000 phones a month, is not really manufacturing. They are just merely assembling them there, honestly. If somebody really wants to manufacture here, and if that somebody wants to come in and talk to central government and union government in Delhi about some more tariff relief, you know, some more easing on barriers, etc., unfortunately, even this government, NDA government, has not been very helpful. This is what the feedback I have gotten from large manufacturers who wanted to come in, set shop. I've traveled to South Korea. I've traveled to the US. I've met with many of these large manufacturers who wanted to come in. They were very keen because they've been telling me that, you know, China is getting expensive. I've started looking at other options. I'm looking at Malaysia. I'm looking at India. I'm looking at, you know, another Southeast Asian country, etc., etc. So how can you make it better for us? Unfortunately, the ball is not completely in our court. While Telangana as a state can offer land, power, incentives which are within our domain, the fact is many of the trade barriers that have been imposed by Government of India unfortunately come in the way of real manufacturing happening in India. That is going to be a huge challenge. Yes, we all want to create jobs. Yes, we want to bring manufacturing to our country. But unless Government of India wakes up from its slumber and realizes that their Make in India campaign is only helping the Make in China campaign. In fact, a lot of these solar panels that, you know, people are now calling, you know, I'm manufacturing in India, are actually not being manufactured in India. They're just merely importing all the products and assembling them here, right here, in the EMCs that we've set up.
The statue of Sardar Patel
also was assembled, also was imported.
Made in China.
So. Made in China. L&T takes claim for it, of course. But it was, again, made in China. The fact is, we have a long way to go, a lot of ground to cover, especially from union government's perspective. They can't just be resorting to sloganeering and not really come out with policies to back them up. Unfortunately, that has been the thing, that has been the case even in this government, on which many of the businessmen, many of the businesswomen had a lot of hopes on Prime Minister Modi and his government. But unfortunately, we have to come to the realization that this government also has not delivered on the promise.
Because it is election season, and despite my desire not to get too political here, can't stop myself from asking, because it's constantly in public discussion, because of the charge by the Congress in particular, explain to us the relationship of TRS with BJP, beyond the state government, central government.
Congress ka bas chale to zabardasti shaadi bhi kara denge hamari. See, I'll tell you what. KCR Garu is the chief minister here of Telangana. Narendra Modi ji is the prime minister of this country. We may not see eye to eye on many things. We may not see eye to eye on our policies with respect to, you know, a lot of things. Fact is, when you've been chosen by the people of Telangana to run a state, and when the Honorable Prime Minister has been chosen by the people of this country to run the country, we have no choice but to work together. That's what democracy is all about. Put your differences aside, set your differences aside, set your ideological issues aside, and work together. That's what we did. And if Congress or our opposition, agar is zabardasti hamara shaadi karwana chahte hain, to hum kya karein? Dekhi, simple baat hai. People think that we criticize Congress more and BJP less. Yaar, BJP hai hi nahi state mein, to hum kya karein? Kisse lade? Koi dushman hai hi nahi, to kahan lade? Our principal opponent here is Congress. So, aap zyada shor sharaba Congress ke bare mein sunenge, obviously. BJP ke bare mein zyada bol nahi sakenge, isliye kyunki BJP hai hi nahi. Aaj unke 5 MLA hai wahan pe, 5 MLAs in the house. I can confidently say, and if there are any BJP supporters, don't get me wrong, I can confidently say out of the 119 seats that BJP is going to contest in Telangana, they are going to lose deposits in more than 100, and out of their 5 jo abhi house mein hai, shayad hi ek bhi wapas nahi aaye hain. Main comment ke saath nahi keh raha hu. I am talking based on the kind of rejection, the kind of mood the people seem to be in with respect to BJP in Telangana. Now, I'm not talking about Delhi, I'm not talking about anything else right now. We'll talk. Isse bolte hai na cricket mein, agli ball khelo fir baad mein, next over agli ball phir khelte hain. Parliament ke bare mein baad mein baat karenge, but assembly mein filhal, more than 100 seats BJP is going to lose their deposits, and not a single MLA of theirs might come back. So why is zabardasti relation? Now, yes, we've supported some of their policy initiatives. We've supported GST, which I still believe is good for the country. One nation, one tax, I think it has eased the pain of a lot of businesses. Yes, small businesses, medium businesses have suffered a bit in the transition. I've actually had to go through a rough ride initially. But in the long run, you'll realize that it will help you. So therefore, I think it's better to clean our books. It's better to make sure that we do business the way it has to be done. And it is going to help us all in the long run. Because once you build your credit history, once you build your business, and once you want to scale up, I think having a good history, having a good track record would only help you and not hurt you. Secondly, we also supported demonetization in the beginning. When our Honorable Chief Minister reached out to the Prime Minister, aaj din kyun kiya aapne? Unhone kaha, sampurna kranti ki taraf le jayenge aapko. Humne yakin kiya, bharosa kiya. Hume laga ki wo imandari ke saath isko aage le jana chahte hain. Unfortunately, he left it midway. He talked about, the narrative kept changing with respect to demonetization. Initially, it was about black money. Phir baad mein ban gaya counterfeit currency ke bare mein. Then it became a story about terrorism. Then it became how, I don't know, abhi pata nahi aaj ka latest kya hai, mujhe nahi pata.
Digital currency,
digitization, cashless India, etc. So the narrative kept changing. But the fact is, Narendra Modi at some point has to admit demonetization was a mistake. He would just tarah usko chahte the, how he wanted it to pan out. It did not. And it is good in politics sometimes to admit ki bhai hamare saath bhi galti ho gaya. Koi baat nahi, log bharosa karenge kyunki people understand, after all you are human too. Yeah. You know, you are the Prime Minister, that doesn't mean you are a demigod or god. Aap bhi insaan ho, galtiyan ho jate hain. But he hasn't so far. So therefore, a lot of issues where, you know, we had to take a principled stand, we have taken. But that does not mean we have anything with them. And I can assure you, hamare ideologies bilkul nahi milte hain. There is no question of working or supporting the BJP at all.
So on the issues where you are against them, you will never change and you will always stick to your principles?
I'll tell you one thing very, very clearly. BJP as a party has certain philosophies and has certain ideologies which TRS and KCR Garu will never ever conquer with. So there ends the story. There can never be a question of BJP and TRS agreeing on some issues which divide, which have divided the nation in the past. I'll not want to go in depth into it. But there are issues which have caused lot of acrimony, lot of bitterness, lot of angst among people. Now, we do not want to, tread that path again.
I'll take you to a very different subject which will interest everybody here, and at least we have a lot of women entrepreneurs here. One of the things you've actually been able to do, and people, when we were fighting for Telangana and there's a lot of debate there, said certain things cannot be done if Telangana is given. One was electricity, you've turned it around. There were fears of Naxalism, law and order, you turned it around. One of your most stupendous success, I feel, which is not talked about, in a kind of time when it is a big debate all over the country, is women's safety. You've actually made Hyderabad one of the safest cities for women in India. How many of you agree with that? I mean, it's there. So, speak to us about how important are women, especially your working women and entrepreneurs, to your government, because it's not often we discuss about them in political discourse. We talk about farmers, we talk about, and they are important. Women, women's safety, women entrepreneurs.
Why confine ourselves to working women and women entrepreneurs? I think women who are homemakers, women who are, single mothers, women who are doing so many things on their own, and also working women and women entrepreneurs, all of them in fact. I think you have to realize one thing, very, very, it's not just about women's safety, or it's not just about safety of entrepreneurs. What we've done when we've assumed office is, see, you do, when you do look back about 4.5-5 years, हमारे बारे में इतने सारे डाउट थे टीआरएस के बारे में इतने सारे अफवाहें थे so many rumors, so many biases, so many prejudices, so many people who had apprehensions about TRS. TRS एक शिवसेना जैसा आउटफिट पहले आंध्रा वालों को भगाएंगे फिर बाद में दूसरे राज्यों से जो लोग आके यहाँ पे हैदराबाद में बसे उनको भगाएंगे कुछ भी मतलब हर चीज यू नो एवरीथिंग वी सेड was misconstrued, misinterpreted, and it was put in the public domain to make us, as demons and as villains. But when we kept insisting that once Telangana is formed, you will see us focusing on governance and governance alone. Not many people bought into it. But Sriram, if you remember, 2014, in Hyderabad city, we only got 2 seats out of 24. Only 2 assembly seats out of 24. वो इसीलिए नहीं था क्योंकि हम पे जो लोग कंटेस्ट कर रहे थे उनके तरफ बहुत ज्यादा प्यार था वो इसीलिए था क्योंकि टीआरएस पे बहुत सारे डाउट थे इनको हराना जरूरी था ये उस दिन का सोच था बट द फैक्ट इज फ्रॉम 2014 अप्रैल व्हिच इज व्हेन द इलेक्शंस हैपेंड टिल 2016 दिसंबर टिल जीएचएमसी व्हेन दैट हैपेंड यू कुड सी द ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन क्लियरली You could see how the mood of the people in Hyderabad started shifting. And one of the principal reasons to which I attribute it to is law and order. Because Hyderabad itna, I was raised in Hyderabad. I was born in Karimnagar. I moved here when I was in my 4th or 5th grade. I went to St. George's Grammar in Abbots. And I remember very well. Har saal, Ganesh ke time pe, zarur 2-4 din curfew lagte the. 2-4 दिन कम से कम हॉलिडे पक्का हॉलिडे हर साल विदाउट एन एक्सेप्शन बीट कांग्रेस और टीडीपी जो भी सत्ता में था मैं आज आपको सोचने को मजबूर करता हूं आई रिक्वेस्ट यू ऑल हैव वी सीन इवन एन आवर ऑफ कर्फ्यू इन द लास्ट 4 years इन हैदराबाद सो इट वॉजंट जस्ट वुमेन सेफ्टी और सेफ्टी ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर सेक्शन विच वॉज एप्रिहेंसिव इट वॉज अबाउट द वेलबींग ऑफ द ओवरऑल सिटी It was about keeping the city safer. We've started some very, very unique initiatives. For instance, we started an initiative where we wanted to put up 1 million or 10 lakh surveillance cameras in the city. I'm happy to share with you, more than 5 lakh have been installed. More than 5 lakh, 50% have been installed. The rest is underway. If you pass by road number 12 in Banjara Hills today, you'll see a huge 2 twin towers coming up. That is going to be up and running in 6 months. It is going to be India's best command and control center, and it will be run by the police department. wherein we'll get all the feed from these 10 lakh cameras, not just for law and order purposes. Tomorrow, for instance, there could be flash floods in Hyderabad. You might need disaster management mechanism. So including the chief minister and his team of ministers, all of us could be stationed there, the command control center. Take stock of the situation, make things work the way they're supposed to work, keep the city running, like they say. So broadly, the agenda has been to make the city safer, but at the same time, there have been instances where we've taken special pains to ensure our women, especially those who are in the workforce, have been kept safer. When Tata Consultancy Services was launching their large office in Adi Batla, right now near the airport, that's the only large office complex which is there. They have about 7,000 to 8,000 people now. They have the ability to have 20,000 plus people working out of there. So they came to us. Mr. Ratan Tata was here. He met the chief minister and he said, "I'm worried about the women who work there, because it's in the middle of nowhere. I want you to do something to give us confidence." Within 7 days, chief minister did two things. One, he'd gotten a brand new police station, fully staffed, sanctioned right there. Second thing he did was a fire brigade and a fire station, large one, again, sanctioned right there. That inspired them to add more and more headcount and more women employees in TCA's office in Adi Batla. Same is the case with the Kachi Bauli and the IT corridor there. And a lot of the financial district. If you look at the IT corridor there, there is something called Cyberabad Security Council. They work very closely with the government. We've launched some facilities like she shuttles, she teams. Now, all of these have been extremely helpful. In fact, one of the things I also wanted to narrate today, a friend of mine, I don't want to name names, he's actually in the room somewhere. He gave me a personal anecdote. One day I went to his place in the evening for dinner. So he was sharing his experience. His wife went to a supermarket in Hyderabad somewhere, and somebody misbehaved with her. Somebody was clicking a picture or something. She came back home, she told him. He wanted to actually call me, complain that somebody was misbehaving. He chose not to. He wanted to test how this institution that we built called She Teams actually works. He dialed the She Team number, 100 I think it is, and complained to them. Within 2 hours, he got 3 calls. Firstly, confirming the identity. Secondly, again, he got a call back saying those people have been, just detained. And thirdly, after they've been detained and nabbed, the cell phones were taken away and they were asking if he wanted to press charges. Within 2 hours, 3 calls were made. Point I'm trying to make is, it's not individuals that matter. See, the commissioner of police today could be a very good man, very efficient man. But once he goes away, what happens to the law and order? It's about making institutions more permanent. It's about processes taking precedence or processes superseding persons and personalities. So therefore, we believed in creating institutions which have this long-term, long-lasting impact in ensuring that women's safety becomes one of the core agendas of law and order inside the city. While we have not really gone to town talking about how safe women in Hyderabad are, I'm happy to share with you, at least 7 states have reached out to us, 7 different states in India, to study the She Teams model. And by the way, She Teams are not only in Hyderabad. She Teams are also in district headquarters. She Teams are also in smaller towns. And we are going to take them further, down the road and down the process as well, to make sure that a woman in rural Telangana feels as safe as a woman in Hyderabad also.
Agla sawal. मैं अगला सवाल हिंदी में पूछूंगा क्योंकि आपने हैदराबाद में इतना काम किया आपका क्या अनुमान है कितने सीट टीआरएस जीतने वाली है इस बार
हम अगर सारे के सारे जीत जाएंगे तो इतराज है आपको
बिल्कुल नहीं इतराज आपके पार्टनर को होगा कि उनके लिए भी 7-8 सीट छोड़ दीजिए एमआईएम आपके दोस्त हैं
तो 7 सीट उनके लिए छोड़ देते हैं
चलो अगला सवाल मेरा ये होगा कि क्योंकि चुनाव एक तरह से एक पॉलिटिशियन के लिए और एक नेता के लिए एक अप्राइजल सीजन जैसा है तो जब आप पिछले 4.5 साल को देखते हैं तो आपके जहन में आता है कि ये एक काम मुझे करना चाहिए था मैं नहीं कर पाया सम रिग्रेट मे भी आपने सोचा होगा कि अगले बार करूंगा लेकिन पिछले 4.5 साल में आपने इतने अचीवमेंट्स के बीच कोई ऐसी चीज जो आप करना चाहते थे ना कर पाए हो या आपको लगा कि उतना सक्सेस ना मिला हो जिसके बारे में आप बात करना चाहेंगे?
एब्सोल्युटली, इनफैक्ट हिंदी में बोलूं?
योरिश इंग्लिश,
आई ट्राई हिंदी, माय हिंदी इज नॉट एज गुड एज योर्स.
आई स्टडीड इन
फैंटास्टिक हिंदी मैन. हाँ, हैदराबादी.
अगला सवाल हैदराबाद में,
वही चलता
हैदराबाद में,
चलता सब चलता. सो पिछले चार सालों में वन ऑफ द एरियाज जहां मुझे पूरी सेटिस्फैक्शन नहीं है वो है हैदराबाद के रोड्स. आई एम नॉट हैप्पी विद द वे हैदराबाद रोड्स हैव यू नो बीन रिस्टोर्ड. इनफैक्ट आई हैव टू एडमिट, आई हैव टू बी कैंडिड, हैदराबाद में कुल मिला के 9000 किलोमीटर के रोड हैं. इसमें से 4000 किलोमीटर हमने ही खोदा है क्योंकि हैदराबाद के चारों तरफ जो पेरिफेरल म्युनिसिपैलिटीज थे जो जीएचएमसी में मिल गए, मर्ज हो गए, उसमें कोई वाटर सप्लाई का वहां पे सुविधा नहीं था. तो व्हेन वी अज्यूम्ड ऑफिस वी स्टार्टेड अ लार्ज प्रोजेक्ट विद 2000 करोड़ एंड दीज 13 म्युनिसिपैलिटीज जहां पे कोई पानी का सुविधा नहीं था वहां पे हमने हड़कों से एक लोन लेके उसको कंप्लीट करने की कोशिश की. तो उसमें 3000 किलोमीटर में ही खोदना पड़ा. इसके अलावा हैदराबाद मेट्रो चालू है तरफ, उनका भी काम चालू है. और तीसरा था एसआरडीपी, द स्ट्रेटेजिक रोड डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम, जो आप अंडरपास फ्लाईओवर जो बनते देख रहे हैं आप. तो ये सारे ही चीज ऑलमोस्ट 10,000 करोड़ का वर्क अभी एसआरडीपी में भी चल रहा है. इसकी वजह से हुआ यह है कि हैदराबाद के रोड्स हैव टेकन अ बीटिंग, आई विल एडमिट टू दैट. बट जब कोई, दिस इज वेयर आई हैव अ प्रॉब्लम, दिस इज वेयर आई हैव नॉट बीन एबल टू क्रैक द पजल, दिस इज वेयर माई ओपोनेंट्स इनफैक्ट कीप टॉन्टिंग मी कि हैदराबाद के रोड देखो. हाँ, मैं मानता हूं कि हैदराबाद के रोड जिस तरह होने चाहिए वैसे नहीं है. वो इसीलिए क्योंकि हमारा रेस्टोरेशन जो करना चाहिए था वो ठीक से नहीं हुआ. नाउ आई एम ट्राइंग टू फिगर आउट वेज एंड मीन्स टू एड्रेस दिस प्रॉब्लम वंस फॉर ऑल. वन ऑफ द रेडिकल थिंग्स आई एम गोइंग टू प्रपोज इन द नेक्स्ट गवर्नमेंट इफ केसीआर गारू वंस अगेन इंटरेस्ट मी विद म्युनिसिपल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, विच आई एम नॉट वेरी कॉन्फिडेंट अबाउट राइट नाउ. बट मैं एक प्रपोजल तो जरूर लगाऊंगा. वो ये है कि हैदराबाद के अगर मेन रोड आप देखेंगे जो 6 lane और 4 lane और अबव, दैट इटसेल्फ विल बी अबाउट 900 किलोमीटर्स एंड टू एंड, लाइक साउथ नॉर्थ एंड ईस्ट टू वेस्ट 900 किलोमीटर्स है. आई वॉन्ट टू ब्रेक दिस 900 किलोमीटर्स इन टू अबाउट 9 or 10 यूनिट्स पीसेस एंड आई वॉन्ट टू गिव देम अवे टू प्राइवेट पार्टीज फॉर एनुअल मेंटेनेंस बिकॉज जीएचएमसी cannot do it. I have tried it 3 years. Does not happen. Does not work. I am going to go for a radical solution. No matter my engineers might curse me. They might not even vote for me also. But still, I will go ahead and do this. You will see this happen. And I promise you, I have to get sewerage and drainage right to make this happen.
How often do you hear a politician expressing dissatisfaction with himself, his work and the department? Since you've studied, worked in America, I was asking them about politics and their views on politics. And because there were cameras, they were very diffident. Whereas you see in America, Donald Trump can be criticized very easily. Since I asked them and they were not willing to answer, I thought I'll route it through you to them.
No, Shriram, trust me, after social media has come in, koi nahi chhodta hame, koi nahi bakhta. People say anything and everything, whatever they want to say.
Unless they have a business.
No.
No?
Aisa bhi kuch nahi hai. Off late, you go any place, campaign, koi na koi utke bolta hai, aapne ye nahi kiya. Koi baat nahi.
When you go to meetings and when do people come and tell you, I'm not happy with you?
Yeah.
So tell me.
And I welcome it. I welcome it. If somebody walks up and says, you haven't done this right, I'll try and correct myself if I can. If it's not within my limits, if it is not within my realm of possibilities, can't do anything.
So that's another question, because this is one problem you, they, me, everybody faces. Managing our time. I see you on Twitter. You respond on global developments. You respond. You interact with movie stars, with sports stars. Then you are responding to some petition from some town or village about somebody saying, I'm not getting this. Then I see you, addressing a conference. You have a perfect speech. Then you give a media interaction, and then you go on to do an interview. How do you manage your time? How do you enhance your effectiveness And if you could give some secrets which they could use in their lives, in their businesses.
No, there are no secrets. I don't manage my time very well. I'm ridiculous. In fact, I showed up 2 hours late. So of all the people in the world, time management in me, I don't think I manage it at all. And this whole myth about work-life balance is nonsense. Nobody has that. Nobody has found that balance, as far as I know. And I have definitely not found it. I'll be candid. If you ask, if you talk to my wife or my brother-in-law, they can vouch for it. Because you have to understand one thing. Jaise Bazigar mein kya kaha usne Shahrukh Khan ne? Kuch paane ke liye kuch khona zaruri hota hai. Aur haar ke jeetne wale ko? Wah! Point is, politicians, you know, we are fortunate because in India, agar aap ke photo dikhenge aapko, ek ho gaya politician, dusra sports star, tisra cinema star. Ab cinema star banne ke liye, sports star banne ke liye talent ki zarurat hai. Politician banne ke liye koi cheez ki zarurat nahi hai. So that way we are very fortunate. That way we are super fortunate. And within the limited time that we are given, see, we are given 5 years to govern. And in that 5 years, the first year goes in understanding the job, the nature, the role, responsibility. The last year goes away in again fighting an election. So, bache 3 saal. Agar in 3 saalon mein kuch karna hai, kuch kar dikhana hai, so obviously you'll have to make little sacrifices. Now, thankfully, my wife is understanding, my kids are also understanding. So, therefore, I'm able to make do with whatever little I can. But trust me, Shriram, I don't think if success is a barometer, and if success, you know, by success you mean professional success or personal success, wealth, fame, etc., etc., you have no choice but to work hard. You have no choice but to make small sacrifices. You can't have your cake and eat it too. That does not happen. Agar koi bolta hai to jhoot bol raha hai. Pakki baat. If somebody is partying way too hard and he says, you know, I've earned my right to do it, then I think there is something seriously wrong with that fellow. You have to realize that he must be working hard, but he must not be showing it. He must really be working hard, but wo dikhana nahi chahta. Wants to be that cool stud that, you know, main bahut intelligent hoon, main ye hoon, wo hoon. So point is, my time management is bad. Don't even try.
So I'll now take a question from somebody. I give the name if you're here. Mr. P. Kumar Raya, Penchala Kumar Raya. Would there be an electric vehicle policy in the next government, given the needs of environment, pollution, and the kind of jobs?
We've already ordered the first tranche of 90-odd electric vehicles which have come in, electric buses that have come in. Hyderabad has about 3,800 buses, the RTC buses. Now, goal is to transition all of them out, because hum log jab uske peeche jaate hain, especially two-wheeler pe, you know what I'm talking about. So we want to phase them out. We want to phase them out. But the industry as such is one which is in its nascency, which is in its infancy. So the industry is evolving, and there are different models which are coming in. Jahan aapko gaadi khareedne ki zarurat nahi hai, lease pe bhi le sakte ho, or the vehicle will pay for itself. So we are looking at multiple opportunities, and we'll definitely ensure that all 3,800 are phased out in the next 5 years for sure. And the other thing I also wanted to point out, there are opportunities again to assemble. Again, people talk about manufacturing of electric vehicles in India. Nobody is actually manufacturing. They're all lying through their teeth. They're just assembling. We also have had two large companies who have approached us, and we are happy that they are all shaping up very well in Telangana. So yes, a policy is a must to provide incentives to those who want to set up units here, and we will be coming out with one soon, after 11th December when you elect us back.
I think you can give a bigger round of applause for that, surely. This is Tej Naidu Kota. Are you here, sir? Okay, it's another noise. T-Hub is a successful incubator program for technology and other startups. Will there be such programs for SMEs?
SMEs, in fact, I saw Prime Minister's statement today in the newspapers, and I thought too little too late, but nevertheless. He had come out with something now. He's talking about giving a 1 crore loan in 59 minutes. I don't know what is 59 minutes. Sorry? Ek ghante ke andar, na? Well, I'm not going to trash his idea the day one he announces it. Let's see how it unfolds. Let's give the man the benefit of the doubt. He announced it yesterday. Let's see how it pans out. But I can tell you one thing. SMEs, MSMEs in Telangana, in fact, the first large industrial park in Telangana of the SMEs is going to be launched in about 400 acres in a place called Dandu Malkapur, which is beyond Ramoji Film City on Vijayawada Road. And that is going to be up and running soon. That is an opportunity for SMEs to come and take a piece of land and start manufacturing or start, doing your own thing there. That is one. And that park has a lot of incentives to offer. We haven't publicized it because we haven't launched it yet. But we will be launching it. There will be a lot of opportunities. And then we also have 3 women entrepreneur parks. So those of you who are women and are also MSME or SME entrepreneurs, you have specific policies. You have more incentives than any other MSME entrepreneur. We have 3 such parks. One in Sultanpur, one in Nandigama, another one which I don't recollect right now, but we have 3 parks. Jayesh Ranjan, my industry secretary, by the way, uska koi exam nahi hai har 5 saal mein, toh wo abhi available hai. You can talk to Jayesh and he can definitely give you more information. Unlike me, I have to go through an exam, he doesn't. So he can help you in case any of you is interested in wanting incentives or in wanting a piece of land, start your own enterprise.
This is by Mr. Suresh Kumar. You have a nice question. Will you stand up so he can address yourself? How would Telangana government like to involve the BNI network in the development of the state? They are all here to want to work with you in many capacities, not just as entrepreneurs, but they say in any capacity as in volunteering for staff or investments.
Can you expand on the idea? What do you want to do? Karna kya chahte ho? Sorry?
Send me a suggestion, Michelle. I'll send you. It's a long suggestion.
You know what? Let me put it this way. We've had arrangements with other organizations in the past and we've done joint ventures with them. For instance, if BNI wants to come forward, launch an industrial park of your own, more than happy to make it happen. That's one. Second, you can work with us on multiple counts. We are looking for solutions on urban mobility. We are looking for solutions on multiple issues that plague us in an urban setting. If any of you within BNI has an idea, if you want to do a proof of concept, you want to take over a specific area. For example, Hyderabad, shahar itna bada hai. Aur aap log agar ye samajhte ho ki hum GHMC se achha ya government se achha hum kaam kar sakte hai. Let BNI adopt a ward or 2 colonies. Make it safe, smart, green, whatever. Aur wahan ek misal ke taur pe kuch banao. Logon ko dikhao ki ye kaam bhi ho sakta hai. Jahan government fail kar gayi, humne kar dikhaya. So you can participate in the process. See, a lot of us, sorry Suresh, I'm going to be venting my angst a bit, so please bear with me. A lot of us, in fact, are very good, especially in an urban setting, at accusing the government of apathy, at accusing the government of not doing the things it is supposed to do. But the fact is, none of us actually show up to vote. 7 December ke din, main bhi dekhunga, BNI mein kitne log ne vote diya. Point is this. Aap chahe mujhe vote do, ya mere opponent ko, ya nota ko. Vote to do. Because if you don't show up, only those people who show up actually decide the next government. Agar aapke dil mein hai ki inko wapis lana hai ya ye karna hai, wo usko leader banana hai. Agar aap uspe kaam nahi karte ho, bahar nahi nikalte ho, if you don't act on it, what is the point? Lot of this apathy of educated urban voter, in fact, translates into bad governance. My request to BNI is, be a part of the process. Begin with voting, begin by voting, and then this initial euphoria, initial enthusiasm, exuberance, it is easy to demonstrate. But koi cheez dil laga ke usko matlab puri tarah ant tak le jana kshetra saive, it is very, very difficult. So I challenge you guys, in fact, BNI, adopt 2-3 colonies, dekh karke dikhao, jo hum kar nahi paate GHMC, jo hum kar nahi paate government, aap log karo, make them safe, make them green, make them saaf sutra. You know, maybe donate a few vehicles and work with the local residents and demonstrate to GHMC ki agar hum kar sakte hain, aap kyun nahi karoge? I think that will be a great revelation. एक्चुअली
बिल्कुल समय समाप्त सा हो गया है और क्योंकि इसको स्पिरिट ऑफ हैदराबाद कहा गया है तो मैं हमेशा थोड़े आशा के साथ ये सवाल आपसे पूछता हूँ. क्या 2-3 बजे तक रात को सैटरडे के दिन एक्सटेंशन कुछ स्पिरिट ऑफ हैदराबाद के खाते अभी इलेक्शन कोड लगा हुआ है आप कुछ कह नहीं सकते
लेकिन स्पिरिट ऑफ हैदराबाद ये गलत है. Listen. I was surprised the other day when I saw a statement of a Congress leader. वो कहता है बहुत अजीब लगा मुझे देख के. वो कहता है कि कांग्रेस अगर सत्ता में आती है हम ड्रंक एंड ड्राइव बंद कर देंगे. मैं बोला ये कहां की बात है, इससे ज्यादा बेवकूफ वाला बात मैंने तो नहीं सुना आज तक. See, today you have to realize one thing, guys. When you drink and drive, you're not just, I mean, I might sound a little preachy, please bear with me. When you drink and drive, you're not endangering your own life. You might end up hurting somebody really deeply and badly. You have to be responsible. You cannot be so irresponsible that you'll just do whatever you want. When we live in a society, when we live in a country, when we live in a state. In fact, let me give you an example of my own daughter. She was 5 when I took her to Singapore. We went on a holiday. And as you know, our Indian kids in India, Hyderabad, sab chalta hai attitude. As soon as she got down in Singapore, I told her, listen, if you throw a wrapper or a paper or jo bhi cheez kahin bhi, police might come and arrest you. She was shocked. She said, what do you mean? You're there, no? I said, I'm there, but they'll still arrest you. Then she says, why? I said, littering is wrong. And she says, no, you never told me in Hyderabad. I said, I've tried, but you never listen. Trust me, this 5-year-old girl, for the next 7 days, behaved herself so well. Whenever she had a, you know, something to throw, she would put it in her pocket or find a trash bin. She was well behaved. Point I'm trying to make is human beings by nature are wayward. By nature. Agar hame azadi zyada de diye na, takleef hoti hai, hogi. So all these things that we've brought in, drunken drive or whatever, are for our own good. It is not really to put you to trouble or to irritate you, you know, after a long, you know, dinner with your friends or session with your friends or whatever. It's not to irritate you or inconvenience you. It's to make sure our city is safer, our people are safer. So my request is, yes, in fact, we've increased it by a bit. Boss, ek baat batate hain aapko. This party, Congress, is so irritating sometimes. When I became a minister, I said, Hyderabad needs more social life. Hyderabad needs more social capital. So in the initial days, out of exuberance or whatever you call it, I said, I'm going to bring sunburn here. People scoffed. They said, aray, kaisa hoga? But today, Hyderabad has become a destination for EDMs. Hyderabad has so many events happening. Aur usme bhi inko wo galat lagta hai. Usme bhi ye log bolte hai, ye to drugs ka adda ban gaya. ये तो यहाँ पे हर वो चीज जो नहीं होना चाहिए वो होता है. मैं बोला ये कहाँ की रीत है. यू से एनीथिंग एंड एवरीथिंग एंड गेट अवे विद इट. ऑल आई एम ट्राइंग टू डू इज इम्प्रूव द सोशल लाइफ हियर सो दैट आई कैन अट्रैक्ट मोर इन्वेस्टमेंट्स, क्रिएट मोर जॉब्स, मेक इट इजियर फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस टू लिव इन अ सिटी वेयर नो इफ यू रियली वॉन्ट टू बी अ ग्लोबल सिटी यू ऑल्सो नीड अ गुड सोशल लाइफ. यू कांट जस्ट हैव गुड रोड्स एंड गुड ड्रेन्स एंड यू नो ब्यूटिफुल बिल्डिंग्स एंड कॉल इट अ सिटी. सिटी is about its soul. Hyderabad, I say, nahin ban gaya. Today, people dream about creating cities. I'm not going to name names.
Yeah, that was impossible to guess.
Really? But you want to take a wild guess? Go for it. Point is, you can't build a city like Hyderabad just like that. Some people claim, I've built Hyderabad. Hyderabad ko koi ek aadmi ne nahin banaya. Ye shahar jo hai, it has evolved over 430-40 years. Quli Qutub Shah had laid the foundation. Then people like us, over a period of time, kept on adding to the brilliance of this city, kept on adding to the fabric of this city, kept on adding to the beauty and vibrancy of this city. Today, I cannot claim that I have done so many. I may have erected a building. I may have created a small little thing. But to claim that I have created a city, that's nonsense, firstly. And secondly, let me point out, city ka jo soul hota hai, Hyderabad ki khubi ye hai, Hyderabad ki beauty ye hai, and I can't stop when it comes to Hyderabad. This is a city which has got some very, very unique attributes. It's got that old world charm and the new age vibrancy, which not any other city in India can talk of. If you look at Kolkata, I wonder what Didi will say, but I'll say it anyway. That city I don't want to live. Kolkata. Chennai, very, very humid. Delhi, too polluted and too arrogant. Bombay, too hectic. Everybody is running somewhere, I don't know where. Bangalore, can't get out, can't get in. What is the point? Bata kon?
Not for nothing has he found acceptance, love, support and affection from people going beyond limits of a political leader, bordering on the kind of fan following that a rock star, a movie actor or a sportsman has. And just before we end, I'll request him to stand up to give us all an oath. This is just that we will all resolve to vote on December 7th. The oath will flash here. By a small request, agli baar jab aapki sarkar banegi, Ivanka Trump ji aayenge, is baar hamare ghar ke sadak se bhi unko zara airport bhijwane ki koshish kijiye. Ladies and gentlemen, give a standing round of applause KTR, the icon of Hyderabad as such.
Or do we have a piece of paper which we can read out from right here? Or we'll just read this. Alright. Okay, I think you guys... Ikkada? Right here? Right? Yeah, I know, this is easier that way. Cool. Alright, so do we have to like... Yeah. We have to raise our hand. The right hand, please. Ladies and gentlemen, please.
Aye.
Please say your name. I am a proud citizen of
Telangana
and shall vote
for my state
and its people
on December 7th
and encourage all fellow citizens to vote as well. Jai Telangana.
We will make sure most of us click pictures with him. Please hold on. We have taken a pledge to vote. We shall. Yes?
Yes,
we will all vote. We as BNI Hyderabad have been very lucky to be driven by a visionary leader, Mr. Bharat Shah. And I have been very fortunate that he is my father. I would like to do the